straddled it, sat down on it, and then scissor locked it as tight as I could.
It was a desperate move for this father.
Yeah. And then just pinned my legs back like this and then just squeezed for everything I was worth.
He fought back after a coyote bit him twice and tried to run off with his two-year-old son while they were out for a hike.
It was snapping and attacking and lunging. And actually, the reason why it got me on the chest is because it was able to jump on me.
Earlier in the day, the same coyote taunted someone in their car, attacking the vehicle.
Lucy. Bracken.
It also came after two dogs in a neighbor's yard and then turned on their owner.
I just was trying to run into the house as fast as I could, and just as I got to the slider, it bit me and it was trying to get into the house.
But it was Ian O'Reilly who finally brought the coyote's chaotic, dangerous run to an end.
I had its snout here, pushed it into the snow, and then just took my hand and got on its windpipe as best I could, and then put my knee on its ribs to try and pin it.
It was a grueling 10-minute struggle, but his brave fight saved him and his family.
Never underestimate the power of survival, I suppose. That coyote was very much interested in living, but, you know, so were we.